Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghost writer. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly head, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in a rope and I couldn't even fight back. So
welcome back to Four Corners News.
I'm Officer Pagiel.
I'm Officer Phillip.
And this is your local news. All right, let's get right to it. Bring up the article.
LECRAE loses tour date after tweeting that he's done with institutional corporatized Christianity.
Now let's get a picture of him. For those who don't know, LECRAE is a famous Christian rapper. He's been in Christianity rapping for a long time, right? Read that.
Reach Records founder LECRAE revealed that he and his team lost one of their tour dates this spring after sharing an honest tweet about deconstructing from politicized and corporatized modern church culture.
So just because he gave a low hint that he is not down with the way Christianity is set up, they say, oh, hell no, we got to drop this dude. Because if he talked the way he talked, he might have the little Israelite doctrine in his ear. Just because he tweeted that, they say, we got to drop him.
So he didn't even say, I'm done with Christianity. Nah. He just said, I don't like modernized and
institutional. Yep. When people think about Christianity institutionalized, right, they think about Jesus with the blonde hair, blue eyes, pale skin, doing this, however he be doing it, you know. That's what they be thinking about. They don't think about the Bible. They think about man-made religion. Go back.
What the hell is this?
Once upon a time, I thought I was done with Christianity, but the reality was I was just done with the institutional, corporatized, gentrified, politicized, culturally exclusive version of it.
Now, he says corporate, right? Is what he said, gentrified. It's like there's a separation in Christianity.
Right.
That's what he's saying. It's about money. There's a separation. When you go, I remember when I used to listen to the Christian radio shows, they used to have a special section for black people. Right. To rap at night. They only come on Friday night. That's when they play all the black music for 2 hours.
Right, that's the black segment.
That's the black segment for 2 hours from 8 to 10 o'clock. After that, you better shut your black mouth and never play nothing else.
We're going back to white programming.
Right programming. And those are for the urban apologetics.
Right.
What's up with that, urban?
Right, white. Why they can't just be all under the umbrella of apologetics?
Right.
Because they're urban.
A separation. Go back.
The popular MC tweeted on Tuesday. The following day, LECRAE reshared his tweet and wrote, just lost a show because of this tweet. Point proven.
Now go scroll down, right? I want to show you something. Go to the part where it says in recent years. Scroll down. Yeah, read that.
In recent years, some notable Christian figures have claimed they are deconstructing from Christianity altogether after experiencing doubts about their faith.
So experiencing doubt about their faith, right? If you remember last week, we covered a Christian rapper. I forgot his name. But he said that Christianity never spoke about anything that has to do with black. They basically were racist.
Right.
And Christianity is based on racism. Go back.
In recent years, LECRAE admits that he also had to do some soul searching after feeling so abused by fellow Christians in 2017.
What's the abuse? How are you being abused? You're not being locked in a basement. I hope not.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
But he said he got his nigga wake up call. Wake up call. That's what happened. Something happened, and they said, "Hey, boy, don't talk about that." And then he was like, "Ah, oh, Lord."
They're watching it. They watch. Right. If you're black, you're Christian, you're famous, you got followers, they're watching you because they don't want you sending a wrong tweet. Oh, we the Israelites. Oh, hell nah. Shut this dude down. Let him take him away from everything that he could spread a mass message.
Right.
Go back. Finish that.
That season almost made him walk away from his Christian faith. However, the rapper sought out on a journey to reconstruct his faith. Now his relationship with Christ is stronger than ever.
Not strong enough because he's still following that Edomite one.
Right.
All right, let's get some scriptures. Let's get Micah chapter 3. Micah chapter 3, verse 11 and 12. Because that's the problem with them. He's worrying about his tour dates. He's known for that. He's not known for preaching, no nothing. He's just known for rapping, right? Read.
Micah chapter 3 and verse 11.
Read it out.
The heads thereof judge for reward, and the priests thereof teach for hire.
So they teach for hire. They're teaching for money. I lost my tour dates. Who gives a crap?
Right.
You shouldn't worry about that. This is for any other Christian rappers, singers out there. Don't worry about losing your tour date. That's not what's important. It's not your ministry. That's not what God called you for, to be entertainers to Edomites.
Read.
And the prophets thereof divine for money.
Mm-hmm.
Yet will they lean upon the Lord and say...
Will you ask the Lord, is this the way?
Read.
And say, is not the Lord among us?
Mm-hmm.
None evil can come upon us.
And that's the problem with y'all. Y'all think just because y'all in Christianity with the Edomites that no evil could come upon you.
Right.
No, they're telling you, listen, as long as you being a Sambo coon, you down with me, but they're open your mouth and speak your free mind, I'm going to cut you off this quick.
Right.
Cut you off from everything, make you lose money. That's how he makes his money.
Right.
I don't care about your family. They'll cut off anything from you. Read.
Is not the Lord among us.
Mm-hmm.
None evil can come upon us. Therefore shall Zion for your sake be plowed as a field, and Jerusalem shall become heaps.
Let's get 2 Corinthians 6:17. That's the problem. He got to separate himself. They're trying to separate from you. They're quick to say, you know what? It's time for us to let him go.
Yeah.
You know, they have no problem letting us go.
Right.
We always the one begging. No. Hold on. Don't cut me off yet.
Grabbing onto their coat.
Yeah, grabbing onto the coat, begging for the crumbs. What are crumbs at? Picking up crumbs off the table. Come on now. Read that.
2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 17.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore, come out from among them and be ye separate.
God, that's a commandment. That is not a suggestion.
Right.
God is commanding the Israelites, who LECRAE you are. I'm sure you probably seen some Israelite videos out there. There's no way in hell you don't see us. You don't know nothing about us.
Right.
God says to separate. What?
I said he knows.
He knows,
if
man.
If he didn't know before, he gonna know now.
He knows. I'm sure he knows.
That's
God says
right.
What? Read again.
Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And touch not the unclean thing.
That's the big part right here. Read.
And I will receive you.
You want to grow closer to God? God says separate from those people. Right. Talking about, oh, I've grown closer to Christ. No, you didn't. Not yet. Because you have not separated yourself from the people.
Shalom, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on IUIC TV. That's right, I said on IUIC TV. Download the app today. Shalom.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.